Let's send this out. Happy Mother's Day. Hey, Mo.
Happy Mother's Day. Oh, thank you. Thank you guys so much. Oh, that's sweet. That's so sweet. So, I'm home. Aw, thanks so much for the flowers. So sweet, it's so sweet. My day was good. I am home. I did not go to Mississippi. I trust my gut. I listened to Spirit, and Spirit gave me other instructions. And so I did not go to Mississippi because I listen to my gut. My intuition is very strong and I trust it. And so I had to take back my, my agreement to go. But I reached out to the young lady that invited me and I told her that it was out of my control to go. So, and I feel good. I feel at peace with that decision. So I hope you guys had a wonderful Mother's Day. I did. It's been very relaxing and calm and quiet and peaceful and just beautiful weather. I did my 7 miles. I did a spiritual cleansing all day. Just enjoying the presence, the gifts from people. The reaching out and saying Happy Mother's Day, I think it's really sweet. So thank you all that did reach out to me, DMing me, emailing me. It's so sweet to be thought of. So thank you so much. Thank you so much. Happy Mother's Day to all of you all who are mothers and those who mother people. Okay. So we're going to do a, we're going to put Sade down a little bit in the background. And we're going to do a Mother's Day reading here. And we are going to see what comes out. I don't know. We're going to also use my cards and just see what Spirit has to tell us on today. I will give the mothers a healing message for today because I feel like all mothers need more healing. We all need healing, but today is Mother's Day. We got the Six of Cups jumping out, but we're not looking at that. Coming to this reading, Spirit, for this collective on Mother's Day, and show us what we need to see on this Mother's Day. You're so very welcome. Thank you so much. If you need a reading, the link is in the bio, but it's Sunday and I don't do personals. I don't do personals on Sundays, you guys. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, for this collective, for this Mother's Day. What is the message? Thank you so much. Happy Mother's Day to you as well. Thank you all so much. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, for this Mother's Day reading. What's the message for this Mother's Day reading? Bottom of the deck is the Three of Swords. Ooh. So some of y'all could be suffering from some type of a heartbreak. Maybe Mother's Day is not a holiday that is easy for you. I do feel like there's some type of offer coming in here from someone that wants to rush towards you. I feel like there could be someone showing some type of narcissistic traits that may want to rush towards you with some type of emotional offer here. I feel like it's going to be telling you that they're heartbroken about something. They may tell you that they've cut off their family, their mom, their dad. People who are toxic and that they have some type of a love offer for you here. Wow. Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, for this collective on Mother's Day. We got the Ace of Cups jumping out. So there is a love offer coming out here. Pisces energy with the Ace of Cups. We have the Six of Cups. This definitely could be someone from the past here coming in with a love offer. They could definitely be on their knees coming in with this love offer. We got the Moon and the Two of Pentacles. I feel like this person could be juggling something in the background. Something that they've been trying to hide from you. Five of Cups. Wow, this person's really in their feelings with the Moon here, the Six of Cups, and the Five of Cups. There's a lot of emotion here. Maybe you made some type of judgment call on this person. Wow, the Four of Cups too? Smooth operator. Smooth operator. So maybe somebody's a smooth operator. And maybe that's why they in their feelings now. And maybe that's why they trying to come back. Coaster, coaster, LA to Chicago. Somebody got hoes.
I got hoes
in different area codes. Area codes. Okay. What else? But they keeping an eye on you here with this Page of Swords coming out here. All right now. We got the Eight of Cups. I definitely feel like you walked away from this person and now all they can do is watch you or something like this here, okay? What else? Six of Swords. Somebody wants to move to calmer waters with you here, though. Four of Swords in reverse. Somebody's still in a heel. Seven of Swords. I don't know if you're going to be able to trust this person, but somebody got a plan here to come in to try to romance you here. I feel like you got this person blockity, block, block, block. Could be an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, or a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Let's get another deck. Let's clarify this. Somebody's heart is cold. What is this Ace of Cups? Why is this Ace of Cups here? Thank you. Hey, Big Leash. We got the Eight of Wands. So there is some type of a message coming in here for you about a love offer with the Eight of Wands here. Like, I feel like it's coming in rapidly. Somebody wants to connect with you. I feel like this person watches the fuck out of you. We got the Page of Swords out here on the table. And then the Ace of Wands. Look at this Ace of Wands, though, y'all. What I tell y'all when I see this Ace of Wands, this person sitting here like this. Everything you post, they on their phone watching it. They rewatch it. They watch it. They watch it. And they watch it again. This person cannot get enough. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for that happy Mother's Day. Appreciate that, John. This person watches the fuck out of you. It could be an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, or a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Those could be in your chart. But this person watches. This person watches you so bad. What is this moon? They in their feelings too when they be doing this here. They be really in their feelings. What is this moon? Why is this moon here? Definitely could be a Pisces or you could be a Pisces. We got the Five of Wands in the reverse. I feel like this person wants to come in calmly with no arguments. Chariot on the bottom of the deck. This person coming in. Cancer energy. There's a lot of water here. I'm telling you, this person and they feelings. Seven of Pentacles on the bottom of the deck. The Temperance, the Page of Pentacles, and the Emperor. I feel like somebody wants to come in and tell you that they're sorry for not putting in the work and that they're going to do better. What is this Two of Pentacles? I feel like this is someone that is recently new. With this Two of Pentacles, we have the Queen of Wands coming out here, the Eight of Pentacles, and the Two of Wands. There could be some type of a decision that you're going to have to make about traveling, about work, or something like this here. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy, also Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn energy, very strong here. You could be an entrepreneur of some sort, and you're thinking about traveling for work. You could also be a traveling doctor or nurse, or you could work in the medical field and you travel for this. Something about mountains. Somebody likes gnomes. Somebody has some type of fixation with gnomes. Like those garden gnomes or something here. Okay, that's random. Somebody is really into Greek and Egyptian mythology or something like this here. Really strong Egyptian. Very, very strong Egyptian. You are Greek. What is this Page of Swords here? The King of Swords coming out. Definitely could be someone in the medical field with this King of Swords and these Two of Wands with the medical symbol here on the Two of Wands. Someone could also have a tattoo that kind of looks like this. I'm seeing it on your here or something. Or here. You got a nice chest. Somebody still carries handkerchiefs. What is this Eight of Cups? This is a collective. You're an EMT and a CNA. Wow. He just left here, Stacey. And as you know, he's a Cancer. Wow. What is this Eight of Cups? What is this Eight of Cups? They got to fall completely out, Spirit. Thank you. The Page of Cups coming out. Yeah, there's some type of an offer that's being turned down here. Nine of Cups. Someone's willing to walk away from something that's not aligned with them here. I feel like it's causing somebody some type of grief or something like this here. But someone's trying to bring in some type of a sturdy foundation. There could also be a twin flame on your path or a true love here. Wow, something that you've wished for is coming in here. You could be going through some type of a major transformation right now. I feel like you've been going within a lot. You could be an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, also a Virgo, or a Pisces, or an Aquarius. Excuse me. I feel like after a very hard ending, you're about to get some type of victory here. You're about to get some type of victory. Why is this Six of Swords here? Why is this Six of Swords here? Thank you. We got the Three of Wands, the King of Wands. So there is something that you're waiting to go towards here, but it's moving you to calmer waters. There's some expansion here. We got the King and the Queen of Wands, okay? So I don't know if this is a match here for you that's coming in romantically. Definitely could be business-wise. If this is not love for you and this is business, there's definitely someone that you're going to be able to grow with here. The Four of Cups, the King of Cups, the Page of Swords. Wow. And the High Priestess, the Queen of Pentacles. Oh my goodness. It's like, I feel like you're focused on your money, but there's something intuitively telling you that there's someone on your path, or that there's someone that watches you that has a lot of emotion about you. Listen to this. So like, you're somebody's person. Like, you gave this person their groove back. You know, like, this person doesn't have so much emotion for you here. Wow. This is a match for you. Like, this, whatever this person is, this Ace of Cups is coming in here towards you. This is someone that I feel like you're going to be able to work with here. Not just work, but there's a lot of love that this person feels for you. Like, you gave this person their mojo back. Like, if this person had a hard time, like, if you, this person had a hard time getting hard before, they don't have a problem doing that anymore when they talk to you, when they're around you. Or wet. Hey, it goes both ways, okay? Like, if somebody was, their libido was, like, off for years, when this person laid eyes on you, Page of Swords, okay? Page of Swords. Two different decks, we got the Page of Swords. You gave this person the kiss of life all over again. It's the kiss of life. Like, you gave this person life again. I like this. Oh my God. What is this Page of Swords? Why is this Page of Swords here? There's a lot of people that watch you, Collective. What is this Page of Swords? Well, Jesus. This person is watching you and they're about to come in. We got the Chariot. Okay. We got the Seven of Pentacles and the Nine of Cups. I feel like this person is trying to come towards you, but there could be things that are in the way, things that are blocking it from coming together. But this person wants expansion here with you. They want to move to calmer waters here with you, with the Six of Swords. And we're clarifying, of course, the Six of Swords with the Three of Wands, the King of Wands. The Chariot comes right after that. There could be things in between this. I feel like you make this person's heart flutter. What is this Four of Swords? What is this Four of Swords? That's too many. Knight of Swords. This person really wants to rush in. What is this Four of Swords? That's too many. We got the Fool. The Magician. I definitely feel like this person is manifesting as Seven of Swords. This is a plan. Somebody has a plan here. I feel like it could be taking a long time, but this person has some type of a plan. Why is this Magician here? What's this Magician? I'm gonna get into my cards in a minute. That's too many, Spirit. What is with all these cards? Let me shuffle y'all. What is this Magician? Bottom of the deck is the Empress. Wow. What is this Magician? Why is this Magician here? That's too many. Four of Cups. What's this Magician? There's some type of an offer. The Eight of Cups. Someone's trying to manifest walking away from something. Some type of heartbreak here. What is this? Yeah, we got the Star, the Seven of Cups, the Four of Wands. Somebody's wish is trying to come in here, but you have to walk away from something first. Yeah, there's some type of foundation that's trying to come in here towards you. Four of Wands. I thought we had this before. But the Four of Wands, the Star, the Seven of Cups, there is some type of a foundation trying to come in towards you. Again, I feel like there's a soulmate connection. The King of Wands, the Queen of Wands, the Ace of Cups, the Ace of Wands. And this person is just constantly watching you. I feel whatever is keeping you guys apart here is really making this person sad. But I don't feel like they show it. I feel like they're trying to walk away from some type of confusion here, but I don't feel like they show you. I don't feel like they show you that they're trying to do this. But they are. Like, it annoys the fuck out this person that there's things in between. Because I feel like it's just one thing after another. One thing after another here. Why is this Star here? No, he is filling his void with multi women. This might not be your story then. He has that tattoo on his arm. Wow, his heart was fluttering. He didn't want to leave here. Wow. What is this Star? Why? Please take what is yours and leave the rest. The Star. We got the Five of Swords coming out. Somebody's worried about sabotaging something here. But this is a firm foundation, and this is, look, Nine of Pentacles, Seven of Swords. Okay, so someone is like, okay, I don't know if this is something that I want. I think maybe I'd rather be single. Judgment, bottom of the deck. Someone's deciding to be single because I feel like there's fears here. Five of Swords, Seven of Swords. There's fears here. There's a lot of fear here. I don't know if this is a twin flame energy. I mean, we had the King and the Queen of Wands. So we're going to get into my cards and see what comes out. Okay, y'all? But somebody is watching somebody very intently and juggling something in the background. All right, so we're going to get into the violet flames. What y'all saying? Happy Mother's Day to y'all, too. Thank you so much. A lot of fear. I hear that, Rochelle. He is my twin flame. I'm seeing instant karma on the bottom of the deck. So somebody's getting instant karma for something. And I just saw talking shit. Like when I picked up the deck, I saw talking shit. So maybe someone's getting instant karma for talking shit about somebody. I don't know. We'll see. We got lost myself for a little while in instant karma. Somebody's dealing with karma and they're losing themselves. Or that's what they feel like. I hear you make me go crazy. You drive me crazy. We got healer. So you could be a healer that drives somebody crazy. I'm not really sure how I feel about that. Yeah, we got healer. What else? This is a collective. Bottom of the deck is someone doesn't want you to be happy. Uh-oh. What are we about to hear? Show me what I need to see, please, Spirit, for this collective. We got instant karma falling out and peacock. We got studying the enemy. And I fell in love with you so fast it scared me. And superiority complex. We got instant karma and decide what you really want. So for those of you that are new here, Spirit works with me in color. It's also as I shuffle, I get a story and then I put it together as it falls out, okay? So someone looks up to you and we got I regret ghosting you. So someone fell in love with you so fast that it scared them and they ghosted you and now they regret ghosting you. We got impersonator. So maybe they weren't showing you the real them. We got studying weaknesses coming out here. Guys, I'm probably not going to be able to post this one because it's Sade's music in the background. I'm not going to be able to post this on YouTube because they be blocking my shit. We got Drama Starter coming out here, and my past holds me back from you. So somebody's a big baby, and we got You Earned It. So there's something that you need to decide what you really want because you earned it. You're going to get a choice. You're going to get a chance to pick something that you really want, and you're going to get it. We got You See Through Them and Shark. So Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio energy and Catfished. Also Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. We got marriage coming out here. So someone could have been trying to catfish someone into believing that they were going to marry them. Look, snake. What'd I say? And we got so many tears. So somebody crying. We got bartender and talking shit. What the fuck did I say in 411? So somebody drunk talking to a bartender about their life and shit here? Or a bartender is. We got doesn't really like women. Somebody could be coming out the closet to a bartender. We got I need space and fishing for compliments and bow down bitches. Also, don't exhaust yourself on other people's problems. So somebody's a goody two-shoes or something like this here. Or that's how they see you. We got they can't run from the memory of you and up in your business. So somebody can't stop checking out on you online or something like this here. Whoever this snake is that it is keep crying. We got good at fucking, bad at love. So somebody telling their business that they don't know how to love people. They only know how to fuck. We got any curses have been lifted here and touch of class. Also looking for a job. So you could have got your degree recently and now you're looking for a job or something like this here. We got uninterested and decision. Also likes to be licked. So somebody trying to figure out if they want to be with someone or not here. And we got someone wants to reach out. Also, you see through them. So somebody wants to reach out to you, but you see through them and they don't know if they really want to do it because you're going to be able to see if they're telling a lie or something like this here. We got Eating Better on the bottom of the deck. Thank you for the follows. Cancer is a bartender. He got a job at my job. Wow. My ex is out of work. What else? We got somebody close to you and key points. So somebody's up in your business. They're watching everything that you do or something like this here. We got fishing for compliments. So somebody's trying to get your attention here. Someone who told you that they needed space. We got spiking drinks. So I don't know what the fuck this bartender's doing. Okay, we got kicked out. And someone needs to talk to you. So someone who's telling their business that's sitting up here with this bartender or something like this here is telling all they goddamn business. Okay. We got, I regret running from this. I'm trying to tell you. There's a snake that can't run from the memory of you, that regrets running from you. Okay, now they doing is crying. Okay, we got spell work coming out here, but remember already came out that all curses have been lifted and we got broke ass. So whoever this is that is a snake that can't run from the memory of you is having money problems. And they watch you because you're, I don't know, they're up in your business. I guess they having, they ain't got shit else to do, so they watch you. The bottom of the deck is bullied as a child. So somebody could be dealing with some childhood issues or something like that here. Healing some childhood wounds. What else? We got throwing shade. And wearing multiple hats. So somebody be talking about you because you work a whole lot of different jobs or something like this here. So, we got dating with a purpose and drama starter. Mm-hmm. That's his broke ass and hustler. also in the closet. What the fuck did I say? Somebody is telling their business. Somebody is drunk and they're coming out the closet to somebody. They telling it all. I'm not good at loving people. I'm just good at fucking. They telling it all. We got multi-dimensional healing. We got throwing shade and keep smiling. So there are people who's going to be talking about you, or there's people talking about you or something like this here, but Spirit's saying just keep smiling. Don't worry about that shit. Because you got multi-dimensional healing going on with you. You're healing on a lot of different levels here. We got trouble in paradise. So whoever this is that's in the closet is having trouble in their relationship or something like this here. The Cancer and I work together somewhere else. The hate be real. Thank you, Monica. He's really feminine. I got my doubts about. We got bullied as a child, flipping out, and overachiever. So someone feels like they have to do extra because they were bullied as a child. Like somebody feeds their ego, or someone's in their job and they work hard. They try to overachieve because they were bullied as a child or something. Somebody telling all they goddamn secrets, huh? Okay. Somebody's getting drunk, high, or something, and they crying and they telling somebody. 411. Like that's like Napoleon complex. You know, they talk about little short men. Oh, thank you. The short men, they have anger issues, or they try to act like they're so big and tough because they're short men. They have to overcompensate for something. That's what I'm getting here. Like someone feels out of control or something here. And so they feel like they have to achieve a whole lot. That's a trauma response. Okay, we got Panther on the bottom of the deck. We got fishing for compliments coming. That's what I'm saying. What else? We got I fell in love with you so fast it scared me. That's this person over here that's up in your business now. That regrets running from you. The drama started as crying with this so many tears here. With they broke ass. Okay? I'm just messing with y'all. We got studying the enemy coming out here. And voice. So there's something about your voice that somebody's trying to get. Or somebody's trying to take. They're trying to figure out how you do certain things. With your voice or something like this here. We got a father with regrets and material harvest. Also rejected and manifesting. So I feel like you're doing multidimensional healing because you've been rejected a lot. But you're manifesting here. You're manifesting a material harvest that's about to come towards you. We got mission in motion. Wow, if I fell in love with you so fast, it scared me. So this person, even though they ran from you, I feel like they're about to try to come back towards you because they can't run from the memory of you. So there's some type of a plan here. Like I said, there's some type of a plan. What y'all saying? What they broke ass? I'm just saying, it says broke ass. I'm just saying what Spirit said. Spirit's the one who put out broke ass. They got problems with their money. I just reading the cards, okay? Don't shoot the messenger, as I like to say. But somebody talking shit about you to a bartender, or they could be a bartender, but somebody's drinking and they telling all they goddamn business. They like just boo-hooing and telling it because they drunk as fuck or high. Oh, Marie, you're so sweet. Oh, you're sweet. That's so cute. I like to call myself a spiritual badass. Thank you. All right. Let's see what else comes out, y'all. Because it'd be funny as hell. I don't be expecting it to come out and it be coming out and y'all be like, uh-huh. I'd be like, what? Okay. I mean, if you resonate, you resonate. It still like shocks me sometimes. We got control issues coming out here in eyelashes. Also gamble and red hair. So there could be a redhead that likes to gamble. Okay. Somebody, we got ghosted. Come out. We keep getting stuff about being ghosted here. Y'all getting ghosted? Y'all are funny as hell, okay? Girl, you're on point. You're a spiritual badass. Oh, thank you, Monica. You did the ghosting. Oh, okay, well. All right, then. I had to cut that deck in half. That was too thick. We got I Miss Your Voice as I split the deck. So someone misses your voice. The voice came out in the other one. So there's something about your voice. And I saw baby face. So someone could think that you have a baby face and they miss your voice. Somebody reminiscing. I'm seeing pictures. Either someone's scrolling through some pictures or someone has got actual pictures of you or something like this here. I must no contact. I'm still weak on the broke ass. He literally lied to me about being scared of losing me. And then a few days later, I'm blocked. Wow. That's scary. That's scary for real. That's scary for real. You triggered somebody. You spooked somebody the fuck out. They were like, oh, wait a minute. I know I prayed for this, but now that it's here, I'm not ready. that's scared for real, okay? Bottom of the deck is, I'm trying to get through to you. So somebody could be trying to call you or somebody could be trying to actually get through to you mentally, but maybe they feel like they can't. Show me what I need to see, please. We got lymph nodes. Oh, these do have the medical ones in it. So y'all could have some swollen lymph nodes or something like that here. We got, I play tough, but I'm a teddy bear. So somebody got a tough exterior, but, you know, they're marshmallow on the inside. We got to see through them. That's the second time see through them that came out. Okay, you see through these motherfuckers. We got, you are the black sheep. Don't deny it. And gestational diabetes. So somebody could be having issues with a pregnancy here. And we got hidden info. Oh, that's my shit. What else? We got fast in the morning sometimes. So sometimes maybe y'all are thinking about switching up your routine or something like this here. We got cross-dressing and threatened. So someone feels threatened about somebody cross-dressing and we got legal matters. It could be a job. Somebody could be tripping because you're cross-dressing and you work outside your home. People in the office. Or you want to cross-dress and you don't know how they're going to react if you do it. We got drastic coming out here. And hernia. Somebody needs to win brain. Somebody needs to watch how they're lifting something or don't re-injure yourself or something like this here. We got popping up on you. Excuse me? I thought we was past that shit. We got remain positive coming out and sus. So somebody is suspect. They got some type of hidden info here. We got unintentionally pushed you away. So somebody who unintentionally pushed you away wants to pop up on your ass. Some of y'all could be having some migraines or something like this here. Or traumatic. I'm hearing you. Somebody has traumatic brain injury. Somebody got a TBI. Is it a crime? Sing it now. What else? Somebody wants to know, is it a crime that they still want you? And they want you to want them too, goddammit. We got scars coming out. Wow. There is somebody who has, who feels some type of way about you, but they don't share it. Something deep. It's like a, something deep that they keep hidden from you. Yeah, didn't I say migraines? Migraines just came. Because I got brain here. What y'all saying? Oh, wow. That is a traumatic brain injury. Right, Maya. My husband got hit in the head in the military. God dang. Three brain injuries. Jesus. Some spirit saying when the rain comes, it gets bad. The pain. Wow. We got lymph nodes coming out here, and the sky is the limit. So something is big, big, and we got fast in the morning sometimes and difficult to communicate with. So somebody in your family may feel like you're difficult to communicate with. Whoever you are, you know that you're the black sheep, and they think that you're difficult to communicate with. We got city girl. So you could be a city girl. You could be a city girl that your family thinks that you're difficult to communicate with. You're the black sheep, okay? That's why they think that. Bottom of the deck is free will. So someone, you could have took a leap of faith to do your own thing with this drastic and free will, like you're taking a leap on your own. On your own, you doing something on your own. What else, spirit? We got legal matters coming out. So you could be a city girl dealing with your family with some legal matters or something like this here. Bottom of the deck is, I can't believe you want to leave me behind. So whoever, there's something big coming in here for you. And somebody knows that you about to leave their ass behind. I don't know if it's family or what, but they can't believe that shit. Like, I don't know who it is, but they really can't believe that you about to leave their ass behind. Okay. My father-in-law suffers from a TBI. Wow, Courtney. I was Baltimore. Wow. We got trolls coming out. So there could be somebody who watches you that has, like, there's something that you hurt this person. They have deep scars from something dealing with you, and they don't tell you, but they troll you. Like, they watch you. But this is weird. The bottom of the deck is, I'm looking for a spiritual connection. So you could be a city girl and you're looking for a spiritual connection. Bottom of the deck. But after that is next couple of months. So maybe over the next few months with these trolls, you're going to find out who they are. Or they're going to approach you and tell you what's going on with them, what hurt them, or whatever. I don't know. That came out, went right back in. I just saw snow come out. And engage. So somebody's got some type of a plan here. Look, engaged and unique. Somebody got some type of a unique plan to do an engagement for you. Like, I feel like somebody has a plan to ask you to marry them, but it's going to be very unique, very different. Okay, like over the top I'm hearing. We got mom coming out. So you could be a mom that's a city girl. We got liver coming out. What? Okay. Well, y'all partying, drinking a little too much. We got I Can't Be Faithful coming out here and drastic. Well, the drastic was already out and we got excuses. So somebody has excuses as to why they can't be faithful and they're always really drastic or something like this here. I think we were getting that before. And we got laughter is the best medicine. Somebody, I feel like somebody's really uptight and you're stressed out and you're causing your own health issues. Like you got to stay present. We cause ourselves dis-ease by being stressed out. Hold on, y'all. Yes. I'm sorry, I love Sade. Okay. So do you. So someone feels like nothing can come between y'all. Okay, they say y'all strong. Y'all stronger than strong. Okay. We got cheater. Uh-oh. And he or she is dealing with the karmic. I don't know. I don't know. Oh, my goodness. So somebody's a cheater and they're dealing with the karmic. We got fibroids and this isn't over. We got divorce coming out and cold. Oof. You could be going through a really cold divorce right now. Like y'all are acting real cold towards each other. Let's see what came out. We got clap back, come back, come out. So when these trolls come out, you might have to clap back at them. Whoever this person is that got hidden info about how you hurt them or something like this here, you might have to clap back at them. Because maybe you remember it differently. We got intervention coming out here. I just heard divine intervention, and we got love bug. So somebody, whoever this is trying to pop up on you, is in love with you or something like this here. We got beard coming out here and get a second opinion. So I don't know if you having some type of issues with your TBI or your brain injury or whatever this is here. But Spirit said get a second opinion or your liver. We got irresistible coming out. So someone could find you irresistible, but they treat you cold with colds on the bottom of the deck. We got to pay attention. We got getting in their feelings in jail time. Wow. So somebody could be getting ready to go to jail and they could be in their head about it, or someone could just really, really be in their head about their feelings, okay? Because jail time could mean actual jail time. Or it could just mean that someone's trapped in their own jail mentally, okay? And they're in their feelings about something. I think I said that. Maybe because you're irresistible and they see you about to go up with this, the sky is the limit. So they see you that you're in, you know, the sky is the limit for you right now. And they're in their feelings about it, and you sexy as fuck too here with this irresistible here. Yes, this is a collective. Well, thank you, I think. I mean, I don't know. I don't consider myself a medium. I know other people do, but thank you. I'm a healer. And a seer. I'm clair everything. Clairaudient. Clairvoyant. I'm all the clairs. We got mind your business and cheater. Ooh, and we got snakes peeking out back there. And manipulation on top. Oh my God. So if you know that somebody's cheating on somebody, Spirit is saying mind your business. Or something like this here. Baby daddy. Thank you, Earth Angel. You believe they're trapped in their head and in their feelings. They probably are. That's his karma. Told him that too, yeah. It's a lot of snakes. Wow. We got daydreaming and I'm trying to make you jealous. So somebody, whoever this cheater is. So whoever this cheater is, they trying to make you jealous by cheating? That's some karmic shit. That's some juvenile shit. That doesn't work. You get left when that type of shit happens. We got daydreaming. It looks like somebody's daydreaming about somebody coming in between something or some type of intervention happening. I heard Captain Sabaho. Oh. We got spirit is sending messages through your crown chakra. Oh, Lord. We got, I should have been honest with you about my feelings. So, whoever this person is that wants to pop up on you, that you see through, because see through them is here, and that unintentionally pushed you away, they wanted to be honest with you about their feelings now. So, maybe that's why they're going to pop up on you or some shit like this here. We got bright clothes. And look for a sign. Also, spiritual awakening. So some of y'all could be going through a spiritual awakening. We got dad. I'm going to take all of that. And I'm going to put this deck to the side. We're going to look at the love oracles, too, and see what's going on there for the collective. We got trauma bonding coming out. Oh, Lord. So whoever this is that has in their head about something, you could have trauma bonded with this person. The one that's jail time, getting in their feelings, that finds you irresistible. We got a tongue coming out. So something about your speech. You could have a speech impediment. We got, I'm going to make you think I've changed so you'll trust me again. Oh. Who the fuck? That's this crazy ass person that's getting in their feelings. We got colon coming out here and annoyed. We got don't take on something you don't want to. Say no. So whoever, okay, you know who you are. You could be a mom because mom came out. Okay. Don't take on something you don't want to. Say no. Stop being a mom and doing everything. You know who you are. Okay. We also got, I'm afraid of what you know. So whoever this person is crazy down here, is afraid of what you know. Maybe that's why they stay in their head. We got, there's a blessing in disguise coming your way. And straightforward. And letters. So there's something that's going to be, you're not going to have to wonder about it. With this letters here, it makes me feel like it could be some type of a document that you're going to be signing or something like this here. Whatever this blessing is. I'm hearing a title. So some of y'all could be getting a house or a car. There's a blessing in disguise coming your way. Straightforward letters. It's gonna come easy. Whatever this blessing is. We got cluttered in support. I feel like they're going to get a whole bunch of support or something like this with this blessing that comes in. Like a bunch of people that's coming in to help you or something like this here. To help you get organized. And you're going to be supported. Whatever this is. Whatever it is, it's a blessing. I'm going for a house at the voice paper, honey. Oh, he has issues with his speech. Okay, I'm a mom. All right. Let's clear this up and let's see what else comes out. What's that? 278. Hey, how y'all doing tonight? My goodness. I hope everybody's having a good Mother's Day. And if you don't celebrate the American holiday, that's fine too. I hope you're having a good evening. It doesn't make me no matter. Never mind. You should be showing your mother appreciation all the time, not just on a day that someone made it so that you got to go out and buy 50 million things to show somebody that you fucking love them. What kind of fucking shit is that? That ain't nothing but the United fucking States. They got a damn holiday so that people can go and spend money in every goddamn month just about in this motherfucking year. It's Christmas, Thanksgiving, the 4th of July, Mother's Day, Father's Day, what is it, New Year's, Valentine's Day. And people keep falling for that shit. When are people going to wake up? They just want you to spend your goddamn money to run their crazy ass fascist, crazy ass country. Stop it. Y'all stop it. Stop celebrating these stupid commercialized holidays. And just show people that you love them and care for them all the time. Just do it. Okay? Stop spending your goddamn money on that shit. Why the fuck you think you go into the goddamn store, every store is getting ready for Valentine's Day or Mother's Day or Father's Day? And because they know you motherfuckers are going to come and buy it. We got baby daddy coming out here. Stop falling into them goddamn traps. Do something better with your money. Make some wealth for yourself and stop making this goddamn country wealthy. They don't care nothing about us. Shit. Okay, that's my rant. We got brother coming out. Oh my God. Bottom of the deck is brother. So I don't know if we're going to be talking about somebody's brother or if you're a brother or if somebody's brother's trying to reach out. Let's see. Show me what I need to see, please. We got a sister. Oh, could be a family thing. And I miss you and I'm done. Oh, so maybe you walked away from a family member and they miss you or something like this here. We got drip and mother. Could be a whole damn family you walked away from here. Okay. I understand. Been there, done that. We got 3 months. I'm going to let it fall out. We got taste coming out in butterflies. So maybe you're going through some type of a transformation and you're finding that things don't taste the same for you. That's because you're going through a transformation. They ain't going to taste the same again. We got profiles coming out here. And also information. And don't do that. Also be kind. You might get some information about something that you want to, that you need to turn down. But you're going to need to be kind about the turn down. Like when you turn this whatever this is down. We got release coming out here, also winning. And fears. Also in it for the money. Yeah, be careful. There's something that you're going to turn down. Because you're going to get some information about something. You're going to be like, I don't think so. Maybe it's because it's something about just money. We got aunt coming out here. We got the whole goddamn family coming out here. We got all my blessings left when you left. And shut the fuck up. So somebody wants, I told y'all this before, there's somebody who wants you to shut the fuck up because you trigger their fears. I don't know what you be saying out your mouth to someone. This was coming out earlier this week. Whatever you be saying out of somebody's mouth be triggering their fears and they just want you to shut the fuck up already, okay? We gotta set it off. Like I said, they just want you to shut the fuck up because you be, look, fuck it. They don't want to be around you because you be triggering their fears or something like this here. We gotta publish. And holding on. Also Aquarius. And Aries. Okay. And sit your ass down. Okay. Hold on here. I feel like there's different profiles that people watch you. You have different profiles and people see you're winning on all of your profiles. Or people are seeing that you're winning from different profiles or something like this here. Somebody really wants you to shut the fuck up. But I don't know why they keep holding on to you. If they just want you to shut the fuck up. I don't know. Happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day. Wow. So there's something that you need to just sit your ass down on because I feel like spirit is like, I got it. I don't know, something about a family member or something about family or something like this here. What is this sit your ass down? Because this is the only one, look, family, jeans on the bottom of the deck. I can't make it up. I know that's not the way that we spell jeans, y'all, but that's how spirit told me to spell jeans for like family, you know? But there's somebody that you could have released or that you did release in a family or something like this here. What is this? Sit your ass down. What is this? Sit your ass down. We got poison and I'm done and I miss you. What is this? Sit your ass down. We got jeans and unhealed. I'm trying to tell you there's some unhealed family members that you just need to back up from or something. Just sit back and just let the shit show happen, okay? What is this? Look. Bottom of the deck is shine. So there's something about your shine. There's something about your shine, okay? What is so? For this sit your ass down, we got jeans. Call me. So definitely family could be reaching out towards you. We got healthy secrets and stop fucking with me. So I feel like somebody is trying to come towards you and start a relationship with you and your family. They're going to tell you some type of family secrets or something like this here. But I feel like it's going to shock you what they have to tell you with this jeans. Call me and stop fucking with me. Like, you're not going to believe it, whatever comes out. But spirits are saying sit your ass down and just release whoever you need to release. So I feel like somebody's going to be telling you about someone in the family who's been talking about you. But I feel like this person just wants to get in good with you. I don't know why. There's something about your shine. Maybe they feel like you're going somewhere with this in it for the money. But spirit's saying, like, you're going to get information about this. Don't deal with this person because they're just in it for the money, okay? Give me a few more for this collective, for this deck. We got Pisces coming out and shine. So go ahead, Pisces, and shine now. We got connection coming out. What else? So you could be getting some type of a connection with a Pisces. We got Bill Cosby and weirdness. And too much damage has been done. We got drama in October. I'm going to take this. We got fight. So there's something about a fight in the family or something. We got a cell phone coming out here and intuition. So there could be some type of a connection that you're going to make on your cell phone. But you need to use your intuition about it. We got solar plexus chakra coming out and love yourself first. Absolutely. We got Scorpio. So we got Scorpio, Aries, and Aquarius. Also heart chakra. So yeah, definitely feel like you need to balance your emotions here when it comes to your heart. And I feel like you've been doing that. And spirit is saying continue to love yourself first here. Okay. All right, y'all. I'm going to give y'all love oracle messages. And I think I'm going to skedaddle. I'm a Pisces, too. Thank you. Somebody in my baby daddy's family or something already did, honey. They turned on me. I said, especially my little sister. Wow, that's some crazy shit. People have the audacity. You know what I'm saying? People be having the audacity. All right, spirit, give me love messages for this. Give me a sneak peek for this collective for love messages for June. Let's see what's going on in June, y'all. The first half of June, spirit. We're going to look at the first half of June. Let me get these cards under control here, y'all. In heaven's name, why are you walking away? Show me what I need to see, please, spirit, for this collective. Sneak peek for June, first half of June for love. Sneak peek, please, spirit, for this collective. June, first half for love. Show me what I need to see. Oh, you're welcome, Candace. You too now. Thank you, Nana. You want to come back for money. That's what it sounds like in them cars, don't it? Crazy you mentioned liver. I almost died from liver failure this time last year. Wow. Well, I'm glad that you are here. Wow. Look at God. Show me what I need to see for this collective. First half of June. Sneak peek for love, spirit. Bottom of the deck is kisses. Okay. Falling in love, unconditionally loving, giving and receiving affection. All right. Show me what I need to see for this collective first half of June. We got the golden mirror. What else? Wow. Well, there is a lot of y'all, so I'm going to take quite a few, okay? We got the axe and the hammer. Damn, y'all letting go of motherfuckers and shit? What else? Y'all are like, next, next, next. What else? All right, that's enough. Bottom of the deck is palm tree. So maybe y'all are going on vacation or something in June. The first half of June or something like this here. We got the snake and axe. So definitely feel like there could be someone trying to come back in June. Someone that you cut off with the axe here. Could be a runner with the runner here. Someone's missing you in June, though. Ooh, we got seduction twice in a row. Somebody trying to come in and seduce your ass? Is the Sade playing, listening to the music? Huh? That's Sade. Yeah, that's Sade. We got I Like You coming out here. And hand of cards. So somebody likes you, but they're not showing their full hand of what kind of ideas or something they got going on here. We got camera. Someone could be reminiscing about old memories or something like this here. Look, we got I Like You again. We got the pink and the black. Somebody's going to be showing that they really, really like you in June, it sounds like here. Definitely know that something is dead, done over with the axe and the hammer here. But someone could still try to come on back here. Because we got addiction coming out here. They could be addicted to you now, baby. Or you could be addicted to somebody. We got ascending coming out here. So your relationship could be going to the next level in June. We got girl talk and mirror. Definitely feel like you could be mirroring somebody in June. You could have met a twin flame of some sort. And your relationship is going to another level. Look, we got girl talk twice. So you could be telling, girl, I met this fine ass man. Okay. Let me tell you, girl. Okay, talking on the phone to your girlfriends. We got the golden mirror. Self-absorbed narcissist, one-sided relationship, love bomber. Yes, that's the one that got the axe, the hammer. This is dead, done, over. But you may, like I said, this person could try to revisit you again. We got butterfly. Yes, you are ascending, going through some type of, you know, inner child healings. You're going through some type of growth here with this butterfly transformation. Your relationship could also, like I said, be evolving to somewhere higher. We got not enough coming out. And wow, we got not enough twice. And addiction twice. Wow. Definitely feel like there could be some type of a situation going on in June where someone will show a lot of interest and then all of a sudden they may back off or something like this here, or this could be happening now. Okay, but I do feel like ultimately this relationship is going to a whole nother level in June. This is a collective, so take what's yours and leave the rest. If you're not in a relationship, you're not interested in a relationship, then this is not for you. This is just something, this was the first half. I definitely feel like the first half of June could be a little bit rocky for a relationship where someone knows that they like you, but they're still trying to, like, figure out what they want to do, okay? Not showing their full hands here. But they really do like you. And I feel like there could have been something here in June here that I feel like somebody's going to try to reel you in. But then I feel like it's going to be like, they're not going to be putting in as much as they should. But I feel like it's going to change with this ascending and butterfly here. I feel like that's going to change. Like, you're going to let them know, look, you're not putting in enough effort here. You were doing fine in the beginning, and then what the fuck happened? And then it's going to change with this ascending and butterfly. Bottom of the deck is palm tree. So you guys could decide to go on some type of a trip or something like this here together. Seduction. Mm-hmm. You guys could live at a different distance from this person, but Cupid's arrow is here in abundance. Definitely feel like you could live at a distance from this person that's going to come in, but we got soulmates and healing heart. I feel like it's going to be a good, I feel like it's going to be good for you. I do. Heart with the key. Okay. But that's a collective read. Now, I'm going to do signs, the love. I'll probably put those on YouTube, you guys, because I can't post here. They shadow ban the fuck out of me here. So, I'll put the love for June on YouTube. Probably next week sometime I'll start that. Okay. And then I'll put your financial readings up. Let me give you guys a healing messages for the mothers, for Mother's Day. Where's my healing cards? I want to give you guys a healing message. Those are my crystals. Where's my healing messages cards? Did I put them up? Oh, there they are. All right. Mother's Day healing message. You're welcome. You're welcome. Well, I told him that last night, my new friend. He is younger. Healing messages. I did enjoy my Mother's Day. Thank you so much, Sophia. Thank you so much, Michelle. So, healing message for mothers for the Mother's Day spirit. Give me a healing message for the mothers for Mother's Day. What's the healing message for Mother's Day for the mothers? Bottom of the deck is the path to light. I make the conscious choice to move towards the light one step at a time. I transform my weaknesses into strengths by mastering my thoughts. I overcome obstacles with positivity and acceptance. I develop my gifts and extend my light to every being unconditionally. That is definitely mothering energy, empress energy. Show me what I need to see, please, spirit, for Mother's Day. Healing message. Healing message, Mother's Day. One more. Okay, I'll take those. Bottom of the deck is here and now. The future does not exist and the past is gone. I focus on the present moment. I have confidence in life again because here, now, there is no danger. Everything happens when my soul is ready. So your soul is not ready for something just yet. And I feel like you need to stay in the present moment for something that you're anticipating coming. Okay? I feel like you're anticipating something, like you can feel the energy building or something like this here. And Spirit is reminding you to stay in the present moment as to not rush something. Because when your soul is ready, that's when it'll move forward, okay? So we got positive thinking. My life is full of small patches of light. I direct my thoughts to that which brings me well-being. I place what is weighty for me into the hands of the universe. Little by little, the light awakens in my being and I find serenity. Then we have freedom through faith. I calm my thoughts and rise above fear. I free myself of all doubt by entrusting my doubts to God. I have faith in God's perfect timing and placement. I trust His will and find freedom. Yes, you have to let go and understand that as long as you stay present and you keep making the steps that you need to, Spirit is going to meet your footsteps. Like every time you step, the ground's going to be there for you. Spirit's going to have you. So let it go and don't feel like you can control it, because you can't. Whatever it is, okay? Then we have the divine fruit. As I work to improve and free myself, there's a lot of freeness happening here for you, mothers. Like, I feel like Spirit is trying to get you to free yourself from what other people expect of you and what you expect of yourself. Like, stop trying to control everything. You can't control other people's thoughts of you. You can't control what other people are going to feel about you. You can't control that shit, so stop worrying about it, okay? People are going to think what they want to think about you. People are going to say what they want to say about you. It doesn't matter how good or how bad you are or what. There is no, when once people realize that there's no good, there's no bad, that's when they'll realize that they can't keep judging you for whatever they used to judge you for, okay? Or what they do judge you for. As I work to improve and free myself, I strengthen my foundations. My intellect is light, my heart is warmth, and my soul is strength. I am nurtured by the divine sun. The fruit I bear reflects my inner light. And that's what's happening. Like, people are seeing that about you. I really believe that, okay? People are seeing your strength. They see your soul, okay? Trust. I trust life and my strengths. Each moment guides me to the light. Everything on my path is placed there for my growth. And that's what it's about. It's not about good or bad. It's about, do I decide to see that this is a lesson and grow from it? Or do I stay stuck? Do I stay in this frame of mind that's keeping me going through this same pattern? It's not that it's bad. It's just that I'm supposed to be learning a lesson here. And if I'm not learning that lesson, I'm going to keep on going through that same lesson, okay? Goodness, I overcome my imperfections, polish my character, and feed on the positive. Thus, I free myself. Again, with the freeing yourself, Spirit is urging you to free yourself. Thus I free myself, allow my goodness to manifest and become a source of joy. Through gentleness, I offer unconditional support, understanding, and love to myself and others. To yourself and others. You gotta free yourself first, okay? Absolutely. I don't do spells. I don't feel any type of way about them. If people want to do that, that's fine, but I don't do spells. Return to heart. I breathe light and stick to the essential for my soul. The present moment. I calm my thoughts. Like I was saying, Spirit's urging you to stay in the present because that's where you find your freedom. All of these cards has something in it about being free. And the only way that you can be free is to stay in the present moment. Once you start thinking about the past or you... That's somebody scraping up the bottom of their car on the speed bumps out front of my house. Okay, so if y'all heard that, that's what that was. Okay. I focus on my heart and find space to be where my light and greatness are. I find peace and inner silence. Spirit wants you to focus on you and your heart and healing your heart, returning to your heart, being in your feminine energy as a mother, as a nurturer, because we are a big part of the household, and how we are is how the household will be. If you are on edge and you're the mother, everybody in that motherfucking household gonna be on edge. But if you are calm and you're peaceful and you're loving and you're kind, everyone in the household is going to be able to relax and feel free. But if you don't feel free, nobody in the house is going to feel free, okay? Because we carry the energy for the house. We really, really do. And it's like, it's hard to explain this to some people. It's not like the woman is controlling everything. It's just that our feminine energy is dominant. It is. And it can be dark. It can be quite dark. People think feminine energy is all sweet and kind and loving and this and that. And, you know, no. The male, I don't want to say male, but the masculine energy is the kind, the giving, the providing. We are the, okay, this is how this shit is going to run. And if this is not how it's going to run, we need to have a conversation as to why it's not going to run this way. But that is how the feminine energy is. Again, I'm not saying that it's right, but we set the tone as the feminine energy in a household. You know, people gonna know if you're crazy or not. You know, just like my kids, they didn't test me when they were coming up. I mean, they did from time to time, but they knew when it was enough because all I had to do was give that look that made them say, ooh, let me straighten my shit up. It's the feminine energy, okay? Absolutely. Happy Mother's Day. So, yeah, okay, last card. Being true. I am true to myself and others. I remove my mask and stop creating illusions. I have confidence in who I am, and I reveal the good in me. I do not hide. I do not need to hide or prove anything. I replace shame with the power of love and truth. So these are your healing messages, Divine Feminine Mother or Mothers. I definitely feel like Spirit wants you to be free, to be you. You need to find that in you. And if you're in your household with other people and you don't feel like you can be your true self, then why are you in that household? Because the people who love you will accept who you are regardless, you know, they may not get along with you all the time. You may not get along with them. You may not even agree with how they're living or whatever. But they'll still love you. Like, love is not surface love. Love that I'm talking about is the agape love. Is the, yes, I know that we all fuck up love, but I'm still here type love, okay? Like, unconditionally, I don't care if you have to turn the knob 10 times before you actually let the water run because you got OCD, I don't care. I don't care if you have to step over every little crack on the sidewalk because you think that it's going to break your mama's back. I don't care. I don't care if you feel like you have to walk on the left side of the street because you're the man and, well, just in case anything happens, I need to be on this side. I don't care about those little quirky things, and I feel like that's what Spirit is saying, that you need to learn all your little quirks and understand that the people who really love you and care about you won't care about those little quirks, those little weird things that you have. I don't care if you got to clean the refrigerator 10 times, if you got to wipe off the handle 11 times, if you want your house a certain way, people will respect that about you. They'll still love you regardless. Okay. Absolutely. You have to understand that, you know, you shouldn't have to walk on in eggshells in a home where you're helping to build. If you are the mother energy or you are the feminine energy in your household, you should not be feeling like you have to walk on eggshells because of a decision that you want to make in the household. Or that you want to go to someone and say, hey, honey, like, can we do this instead of this? Or can I bring up an idea and your ideas? You should not feel like you can't do that as the feminine energy in your household. Okay. Then, Shay. I feel like you need to sit down and have a conversation with them about how it works for you. What is it that makes you need the organization, and what makes them so messy? Do they have ADHD? do they have autism or Asperger's or something as to where they can't be organized? Have they ever checked into that? There's a lot of different reasons why some adults cannot be organized. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, it helps a lot of people. Well, first of all, organization helps the energy, period. Like, if you have clutter and mess everywhere, what shows on the outside is what's going on in the inside. So if someone is totally disorganized and they leave a bunch of stuff everywhere, clothes on the floor, the hamper's right there, but they leave the clothes on the floor in front of the hamper, or there's stuff all over the place in one area and stuff, they most likely are feeling that way on the inside. Okay, so if you can't fix, the inside has to be fixed first before they can be organized on the outside. And so this person probably needs help too. Sometimes ADHD shows up in different ways. My daughter has ADHD, and usually her place is a damn mess. But with something, she's very, very organized with. But other things, like clothes and shit, mm-mm. No way. No ma'am. No ham. No turkey. So your ADHD needs you to be organized for stuff like that. So you have to be understanding. Okay. He's medicated too, though. Well, then maybe he needs to go to a different doctor because maybe that medication ain't working. I myself think that there are probably natural things that you could do to help get off of the Western medicine. But that's just me. Also, there could be the diet of the person that you're talking about. Maybe their diet isn't mixing with the medications correctly. There's some things that you have to give up when you're on those medications and you have ADHD because the foods are not good. They're not real. So they fuck with the medication. So think about this, Shay. Brooke, if you're telling me that it's been every man that you've been with, who is the common denominator? I'm sorry, but I don't sugarcoat anything in here, and I don't spare people's feelings. Sometimes we need to be told the truth even when we don't want to hear it. Sometimes when we think it's everybody else, it's really something that we're doing that's the issue. Sometimes we have to take a look in that mirror. And sometimes that can be very hard. Especially if you're saying it's like every man. So that means that there's something that you need to turn inward and look at. Because every man... Okay. Good for you, CC. You taking notes? Thank you for sharing my live, Amber. Yeah, I have OCD as well. I try not to, but it's really, it's a trauma response. And it's something that I'm still healing. I'm not as bad as I used to be. I mean, I used to drive my kids fucking crazy. And I knew I did, but I couldn't help it, especially after my mother died from COVID. I mean, I was crazy with the cleaning, with the... Oh, man, when I look back... And after my mom passed away from COVID, I was extremely bad. Like, I couldn't go anywhere. I would be getting anxiety and panicking if I had to go to the grocery store. And it was just horrible. It was horrible. And I knew it was more so because I was tripping because my mom died from COVID. And I knew it had to be someone gave it to her. you know. So it was just, it was horrible. It was horrible. When I think back at it, it's like, oh my God, my poor kids. I knew that I probably fucked their little heads up during that time. Oh my God. Yeah, my mom did. She was actually in a nursing home that I did not want her to be in, but her husband at the time wanted her to be there because he didn't want to take care of her at home, or he couldn't. I don't know which one it was. I mean, I really feel like it's because he didn't want to, but that was neither here nor there. And she was in a nursing home. And she got it from someone, worked at the nursing home. It happened right before they shut the nursing homes down. And I remember them calling me and telling me she had a fever. And I knew that it wasn't going to be long once they told me that. It was horrible. Either way. Oh, it's okay. Yeah. Oh, but my mom has been so active in my spiritual awakening. Like, she's the main one I know that led me out of the situation that helped push me further into my spiritual awakening. It was her. It was definitely her. And she's still around me a lot. Like, she makes herself known all the time. And I'm thankful, I'm grateful for that, because I have a really good relationship with my mom. Even though the first half of my life, we did not. But the second half, before she died, we did end up having a really good relationship. I have healed from that, like... it was difficult at first because I was grieving alone. I didn't have, my sister to me could have cared less that our mother passed because of the past that we had with our mother. None of my family reached out and told me that they were sorry about the passing of my mother. I just had my children. And this happened 3 years ago. So they were, you know, young. My oldest at the time was 22. And then everybody is down from there. My youngest was 15. And it hit him hard, you know, when his grandmother passed. But all I had was them. Like, and during COVID, of course, with the funerals... Oh my God, like we couldn't touch each other at the funeral home. They had our seats. They were only allowed to be 12 people there, first of all. And we have a big family. So it was confusion, to say the least. And then we couldn't touch each other. We couldn't go all the way up to the casket. She looked absolutely beautiful. I do remember that. But it was so bad. It was so bad. Like, we couldn't touch each other. We couldn't nothing. And we hadn't seen each other. Like, the people that were allowed to come, the grandkids, me and my sister, her daughter. It was bad. It was so bad. You know, I'm so thankful that she chose to go. And I know that she chose to go because she wasn't a sickly, sickly person. But I know that she chose to go to help me go into my spiritual awakening. And I say that because the person that I was with was doing me dirty. And I didn't even know it. At the time, 1, 2, 3 people in here as I look up. At the time, I was wearing rose-colored glasses and really thought that this person was amazing. You know, I thought that we were going to spend our life together. We had been dating for almost 3 years. He had asked me to marry him. My mother had met him. And then I started getting really weird signs and signals. And I was like, and this was after my mom died. And I was just like, I know I'm not seeing what I'm seeing. And I started waking up. I started waking up and she started doing things in my room, showing me things and stuff like that to get me moving. And so once I got moving and everything is when I really started to wake up and I saw the things that this guy was doing. And I was like, he's moving weird. I was waking up and it was my mom who was waking me up because she was showing me shit. Like, do you fucking see this shit? Do you not see this shit? Like, she was like, come on, baby. Like, wake up. Don't you see this? And I finally woke up and I started packing up. I wasn't living here, of course. I was still in this city. I was living somewhere else and I started packing my house and I was like, it's time to go. And it was like she was saying, yes, it's time to go. It's time to go. And then the final push was when this man's I don't know what to call her, his baby mom, called me from his phone at 2:00 in the morning. I tell you guys, it was the biggest surprise in my life. This man had a child with this woman and they were all way on the other side of town. At 2:00 in the morning. Now I'm thinking it's him because it's his phone number popping up on my phone. So at 2:00 in the morning, I'm thinking, oh shit, what happened? I pick up the phone and it's because it says the guy's name. And I'm like, hey, what's going on? I'm still laying in the bed because I'm half asleep, laying back, got my daggone, you know, scarf on and everything, y'all. And I'm like, hey, what's going on? Everything okay? And the voice on the phone, a woman's voice, says hello. I'm like, I'm laying back and I sit straight up in my bed and I'm looking at the phone. Am I seeing this shit right? Hello? It's funny now, but it wasn't funny then, y'all. It was not funny then. Like, my heart was in my motherfucking stomach. I'm telling you, after I got off the phone call with that woman who told me she had been with this man for 10 years and they have a child together and she had other kids, I threw up for like a half an hour straight. For like a half an hour straight, I threw up. Like, I was so emotional. I was sick. I was violently sick. And, you know, now I can look back at it and be like, thank you, Jesus. Because I dodged a motherfucking bullet. After that, I really started packing up my shit, y'all. It's like God said, and my mom was like, okay, now go. And so the next day, I started packing all my shit. I started making plans to put shit in storage. The girl that called me from his phone called me again and told me that he had beat her up because she told him about me. Because she told me about him. I'm sorry. Like, this girl's hair was ripped out of her head. He broke every last one of her fake nails off. I mean, like, to the point where her fingers was bleeding and shit. And I had never seen this side of this man. Like, ever. And I threw my stuff in storage and we and my kids moved into a hotel. And everything's been on the up since then. That's just part of my story, y'all, but that is what really threw me into my spiritual awakening, was that right there. Listening to spirit and spirit telling me the next moves. And I mean, I was tuned in. After, I'm telling you, I was tuned in, and it was nobody but God and my mom that led me every step of the way. And meditating, them being able to connect with me and saying, okay, this is the next move, this is the next move. Because I was scared. I didn't know what I was going to do. I had no idea. And after living in a hotel for 3 months with my children, I ended up having to go stay in a shelter because I ran out of money. Staying in a hotel for 3 months was very expensive with children. You know, we still had to eat. We still had to get back and forth to school and all the other stuff. Still had to pay the insurance on my car. We had to wash our clothes. There was no kitchen in the hotel. You got to spend money. We were homeless for a while. And this is my first place since after being homeless. And things have really been going up for me. And it's been amazing. Like, it's this whole journey, it's been amazing, y'all. So don't ever worry about what it looked like. I don't care what it looks like. If you're still alive, it's not over. It's not over. I don't care what people try to put on you, what they try to say to you, what they try to make you remember about your past, about how you used to be. When God wakes you up and takes control of your life, can't nobody take anything away from you that God has given to you. It's such an amazing feeling. I am protected. I am so protected. Yes, and you know, but it was because it was the last lesson that I needed, because I still needed that push to see who the fuck I am. Because back then, I was still overgiving and trying to make something work that wasn't working. We were truly on two different frequencies, and I was trying to make it work when it wasn't working. Like, there was no way it was going to work. This person was for the streets, but they hit it very well. They hit it very, very well. And then the mask started to slowly fall off because they couldn't keep it up anymore. So I needed that lesson, because that lesson made me realize who the fuck I am. And that, like, I'm a bad bitch. Like, I'm so protected and I'm so, so gifted. And I know these things now. And so I have to thank that person, and they know who they are, that took me through all that shit, that made me think that I was less than, that made me think that I wasn't good enough, that made me think that I was only good enough to be a side piece. I bet your life sucks right now. And mine is just getting more and more blessed every single day. I have so much love around me. I have so much joy and peace and mercy and abundance around me. And it's all because of what you didn't see. And God kept me hidden for a reason from you, because you were my test to help me elevate to where I was supposed to be. So thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. And thank your mother, too. I know that that woman had issues, and I know that you have childhood issues that you are trying to heal. But you know what? You really fucked up. And I wish you well. I do. I wish you all the peace and love that your heart can stand, because you need it. You need love and peace in your life, because you don't have it. And that's why you keep on doing all the shit that you're doing. Okay? I really hope that someday you find peace within yourself and you heal those wounds from your childhood that you don't want to talk to nobody about. I hope that you heal those wounds from losing people that you don't want to talk about. Because there's nothing like when you get your peace. You know, you won't ever let nobody ever fuck it up. I don't care who it is. Mom, dad. So, thank you, sir. And your family. Thank you for what y'all tried to do. Because you know what? Now, God is preparing a table for me. And you are going to sit and watch me eat at this table that Spirit is preparing for me. So, since you like to stalk my pages and stalk my friends' pages, and there's a moth in here, and stalk my family pages, and stalk everything that I'm doing and trying to figure out where the fuck I'm living at and all that other crazy shit that you've been trying to do behind the scenes, keep watching so that you can see me blow the fuck up right in front of your face. And it's all going to be so blessed. It's all going to be so blessed. I'm not going to have no hand. It's all going to be God. And you're going to watch it happen. All right, y'all. I'm going to get off of here and stop running my mouth. But happy Mother's Day. I hope y'all enjoyed this reading. And I hope that you guys enjoyed the story time. Oh, you're welcome. What y'all say? Oh, thank you so much. It's healing for me too, Sarah. It's healing for me too. Good. That is my purpose, is to help other people heal. I know this now. Even if it's not in the best way, I trigger people into healing. It's not an easy path, you guys, because people end up hating me. And it's okay. Like, I don't take offense to it anymore. You know, I unfortunately, my thing is to reflect people back to them what they are reflecting to me. And it sends them into a spiritual awakening or some type of healing. And I love being a healer, but it is not an easy path. It's not an easy path. So when people think that, oh, I would love to, think again. Think again, okay? It's not an easy path, okay, y'all? But I love y'all. And I'll talk to y'all. What's tomorrow? Monday? I may be on tomorrow. I got a lot of people to take care of tomorrow. Well, thank you. Oh, thank you, Cece. Absolutely. Hi, Smokey. How are you? Oh, no, I don't try to help them all. I don't try to help anyone. It's just that people are sent on my path, and either it's for a good reason or a not so good reason. I mean, you know. I don't try to heal everybody. They get the healing just because I'm a healer. That's what we do. Thank you. All right. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.